Hello, I'm Julie Faith Ann Balzer, your host on Make It Artsy. Now today, it's all about time. And to get us started, metalsmith Mary Hetmansberger is here, and she's gonna be using clock parts and sheet metal to create some really awesome jewelry. Hi, Mary.
Hey.
So I love these necklaces that you're making, and I did not realize that they were made from clock parts when I looked at them at all. But in fact, that's the secret.
Yeah, they're very interesting. And they have so many different components and colors, you would be surprised. To get started, what we're gonna do is just take sheet metal. So this is 24 gauge. You can either use silver or copper. I actually like to use both. I think it looks really good.
I like that mixing of metals together. I think it's more interesting.
So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually sort of just visually, there's no big measuring or anything here.
Okay.
You're using
the clock face as like a tracing element. And
right.
You're cutting like maybe quarter inch away.
And you know what? It's
ish.
Random. Ish. It's so random. And I just use these metal shears. These are great. What they kind of do is they make the edge really smooth.
Because I was going to say, are you worried that you're not wearing gloves or anything? Are you worried you're going to cut yourself on this metal now that you're cutting it and it's sharp?
No. And then basically, it's very organic and random around the outside.
Mm-hmm.
What you want to do is, this looks like just a piece of metal, and it doesn't really look like sterling, and even though this is sterling. So you want to kind of get it to have an interesting texture and look
gonna
to it.
We're going to fancify it.
Fancify it. Yes, we are. And what I do is I take just a regular old ball peen hammer. I come in and I actually deckle the edges. You know how when you pull paper, you get that deckled edge?
Yeah, you get that nice little edge.
Right. So that's kind of what I'm doing here.
And now you are working on top of a metal block.
Right. This is just called a bench block.
Mm-hmm.
And this one's particularly nice, but anything will really do.
Oh, I was going to say, I actually, in the past, when I've wanted to do metal work and haven't had a bench block, I've actually just used another hammer, which obviously is metal.
Right.
And if you have a very small piece, you can put it on the side of the hammer and use that as kind of a bench block.
If you actually hammer, like, even into cement, mm-hmm. you're going to get the texture of the cement. This is a texturing hammer, and it just comes in.
Oh, and you get those squares all over there. So cool.
Yeah, and if you don't have, you know, if you don't want to buy a lot of stuff, you just find an old hammer that's got texture on it.
Like a junk shop or a thrift store. That's a cool idea.
So what you're going to do is you're going to take this piece of metal, make sure you use some nice heavy pliers, and I'm just going to use a plumber's torch. And I'm not going to really do it because it's just not necessary, but I'm going to run this through a few times and darken it a little bit. This is a piece that's not been, you know, had anything done to it. This is. So you can kind of tell the difference.
Wait, that's both copper?
These are both copper,
and
right.
The color is so different.
Right.
This is like almost like a rose kind of color, and that's more orange.
Yeah, you've definitely aged it here. So the way we're going to now assemble, and these are fabulous. These are just a hole punch here. You want to come in here, and I just measure, and I don't, mm-hmm. like I said, I don't measure.
I have a question. Does that take a lot of hand strength to clench, and to cut through metal?
Not really. They're made from metal.
Okay.
So what's nice is they can handle it. They can really handle it. So when you go to assemble all these, one thing that I like to do is, and if you end up with some metal in the back, you just take it off. These are wire cutters.
Oh, this is such a great idea. So when you punch the piece out, you're just snipping off the excess to clear it away so you don't have that rough piece.
Right. Now, the interesting thing about clock parts is that you've got, obviously, the clock, but you also have this counter enamel that they put on old clock parts, and those are just gorgeous. Great colors.
Unbelievable. So this is actually not a functional anything.
Right.
This is
it was the counter enamel.
So all this beautiful enameling that you see
and
here.
And as you see, the colors, they're just gorgeous.
I die for this green. I think it's
beautiful.
Amazing. And of course, on the other side, there's a watch face. And
there's a watch face. So what I'm going to do to assemble, and I like to mix the metals also. So sometimes I use silver, sometimes I use copper. I'm going to take about a 6 inch piece of copper wire.
I like your measuring. You're like maybe a 6 inch,
whatever.
Maybe a 7 inch, just like a piece.
And I actually visually sort of divide it into thirds. So I hold it like this, and then I grab one of the thirds, I take a pair of pliers, and I come in here and I make a nice sharp.
Are these round or flat pliers?
These are called needle nose. So
okay.
they actually are flat on the inside. They don't have any ribbing. And what's nice is I'm using them just to hold, and then I bend with my hands. So now I'm going to assemble the piece. So I'm going to take, A lot of flat little washers. I think I'm gonna start out with this.
And again, you're mixing metals. You have a copper, you know, wire. You're using what looks like, it's silver colored. I'm sure it's not actually silver, sort of found object discs.
Right, these are little stainless discs.
Stainless.
So the other thing too is now I'm gonna assemble, but what I like to do is I like to put what I call spacers in between.
Okay.
Because when you have your necklace, if you look at this one here, this one, you see how it has dimension? Otherwise, everything lays flat.
Okay, so I was a scrapbooker back in the day, and we used to use foam adhesive, and it essentially on paper crafts does the same thing.
Right.
It gives you that bump of space
right.
between the next
so
item.
So I'm putting these little washers in and just pushing them through. And also on these, be aware that some of these have these little, I don't know, they're
feet
like little metal
or
feet or something. Yeah, you can cut those off with your clippers too.
Now, and I can see the feet on this one right here
right.
sticking up, and you would just take your metal snips and of course
yep.
protect your eyes. I know we have some safety glasses on
the table. I just use the wire ones. This
right.
is a, these are really nice. So I've got all these assembled.
Now, when you're assembling this, Mary, are you thinking particularly like, oh, I want to have something that's orange and silver, or are you just sort of grabbing for stuff and assuming
both.
It's going to work?
Both. I mean, I like to assemble where it's going to obviously look good. But I do like the mixing of the metals.
So do you think that like picking the pieces that you're going to have out to use is actually more important than in the actual assembly?
I think it's nice when the shapes are relatable.
Mm-hmm.
I like the fact that I'm using both sides of the clocks. I always think that makes it look really interesting. And I do like the idea of, like I said, mixing the metals. Once I get to this point, as you can see, I've got my thumb here, and that's kind of important. I don't want to bend this right tight or it won't have any movement. So I actually come in like this, I bend it up.
So your thumb is between,
right,
and that's how you're judging that you're going to have a little bit of a bump.
Then that way I have a little bit of movement. Now I've got this, I bring it together here, I come in here, grab it, and wrap.
Oh, you're just twisting.
It's actually the top of a wrap loop.
So then if we look back at some of the finished pieces, what we'll see is we can see the movement, the dangle,
right.
the wrapped loop. You're even adding a little bead or embellishment. You simply string it. Easy enough.